look who is back from her cruise. Yay! So glad you're back.
Having vacation withdrawal.
I know. I bet you are. But even when you're on vacation, you're still working for us, which is amazing.
I tried to. Well, I loved Rocket Man, which came out last weekend, so I wanted to like tell you guys about that because I loved it so much. But
well, we think that today is going to be sunny. Tomorrow's going to be maybe more of a movie day. And okay. You saw two very different movies this week.
Yes. So Dark Phoenix, which is the last installment of the X-Men films. Of course, X-Men came back out in 2000, mm-hmm. the first one with Hugh Jackman that we all know and love him mm-hmm. as that character. Glory. He's not, yeah, so obviously Hugh Jackman kind of ended his X-Men stuff with Logan, which was amazing. Now we have Dark Phoenix, which was written and directed by Simon David Kinberg, who's produced the X-Men films. He's produced Marvel films, including Deadpool, Deadpool 2. And this is supposedly supposed to be the last installment. And of course, Sophie Turner, who we all know and love as Sansa Stark in Game of Thrones. She's so gorgeous in this, oh my gosh. She plays Jean Grey, and after the X-Men go on this mission in space, something happens to Jean Grey right here, and she absorbs all this power, doesn't really know what's going on, kind of becomes the Dark Phoenix. Now, we've seen this story before in X-Men The Last Stand, which came out a couple years ago, wasn't too great. This is kind of the same story, but I will say, you have to see X-Men Apocalypse, which was the last film that came out a couple years ago. So the recent films include X-Men First Class, Days of Future Past, X-Men Apocalypse, and now Dark Phoenix, which is like the final one. So Sophie Turner is great as Jean Grey, but the standout for me is Michael Fassbender.
You love him.
Michael Fassbender is, I say I have a lot of favorite actors, and I do, but Michael Fassbender is my favorite actor, like, ever. He's so amazing as this role. I know, he is, but no, he's such a good actor, too. He's not just beautiful. No, he's so great as Magneto, and seriously, all of the action scenes in the film, like, he just owns them. He's so good in it. The action scenes are great. I will say, like, the last one-third is just not so great. I feel like they did some reshooting. The dialogue's not great. Jessica Chastain, who I also love as an actress, plays the villain in this film, but they don't explain the villains at all, which is horrible. In a superhero movie, yeah. You need a good villain, sure. And that really annoys me that the villains were just... I mean, she just honestly had terrible dialogue. There was nothing that she could do with it. So I just think some of the screenplay was kind of poorly written. I'm giving it a 3 out of 5 stars. I really enjoyed a lot of the cast. Nicholas Hoult, Jennifer Lawrence, Ty Sheridan, Sophie Turner, Chastain, Fassbender, Fassy. 3 out of 5 stars for Dark Phoenix.
Do you still have the phone case with him on it?
Oh my gosh, I forgot that I did. So I got a new phone. So no, I need to get a new one now. Fassbender, okay. I'll get a new phone case for you.
And then you saw Secret Life of Pets.
Yeah, so Secret Life of Pets 2. So the first one came out in 2016. I'm a huge pet person. I know you are too. And they explore all different types of pets in here. Dogs, cats, rabbits, parrots. The voice cast is amazing. We have Patton Oswalt back as Max the dog, who he and his brother Duke are dogs of this married couple. They bring home a baby. Now we all know how babies can change things with dogs, but it's really, really sweet to see the interaction with the new baby. And I thought that even though it was, you know, a cartoon, it's still mm-hmm. like very relatable. Illumination Studios did this, who did the Despicable Me films, Minion films. Okay. So the animation is beautiful. It's really, really sweet. Duke is the new dog here. He's voiced by Harrison Ford. Really, really great in the film. I do think it's probably about the same level as The Secret Life of Pets 1. I like how it was relatable for both parents and kids as well who have dogs and pets and cats. There's some great cat moments in here that cat lovers are gonna really laugh over. 3.5 out of 5 for The Secret Life of Pets 2. And see Rocket Man in theaters if you haven't seen that yet.
And you have a quick Netflix recommendation.
Oh yes, Always Be My Maybe. Asian American rom-com with Randall Park, Ali Wong, so good. I watched it last week, and it's amazing. My favorite celebrity cameos in it as well, like that I've seen since Bill Murray and Zombieland.
Michael Fassbender?
No. Unfortunately, if it was, I'd be like giving it like a 6 out of 5.
You can follow Lauren, also known as DC Film Girl, on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube, and her website, dcfilmgirl.com. That's okay. We're the same when it comes to Bradley Cooper, so we're there.